All right, welcome everybody. In this video today, we're going to work in plasticity, and I'm going to try to demystify some of the stuff going on with patch tool. Okay, so, and if you wait until the end, I'll show you how patch tool came in super handy to create this guy here. So just hang out to the end and I'll show you. So right now I am working in 1.1.17, which is basically gonna soon to be 1.2 very soon. So, but there are some enhancements to the patch tool, or just some better visual reference. So let's take a look here. We've got this sheet here that was created by that curve there, following this rail here, and it was just sweeped out and it made that curve. And then I cut this guy out, this little hexagon here. So I'm going to select them, and then I've got patch hooked up to my tilde key, and as you can see, we now have new indicators of what's going on here. So basically, this is our continuity, which is basically just the flow from one edge to another, and it wants to know how smooth you want it. So you can go G1 or G2. Planner won't work, it'll fail. See, so we'll go back to G2 or G0. It doesn't really matter this one, because it just knows how to make it perfectly. So, but if you go to 1.1 version, you had them, but it's patch. Okay, so G0 doesn't have anything. It's considered non-smooth. Then you do smooth, and then you get these little dots. Well, that's your G1 dots. If you do G2, didn't really change. Then you'd have to go through here and select all these weird random colors, and you didn't know what was going on. So now you know exactly what continuity you got going on with your edge flow. And the reason you want that is because being able to transition from one edge or one surface or sheet to another, you want to have nice smooth transitions, or your reflections are just going to be just totally out of sorts whenever you do it. So let me show you this real quick. I'm going to patch him. Works just fine, but you notice we don't have any continuity G0, G1, G2, because it's not attached to anything. So it doesn't have any sort of transitions to try to figure out, if that makes any sense. So, and then you also don't have any guide selections. It won't let you do it. You'd basically have to build a guide and kind of piecemeal the whole thing together to make it work. So let's go out of that. Let's go over here. Let's try this real fast. Select him again, do a patch. So let's see what happens when I put a guide in here, okay? Now you can see it works just fine on G0. Everything works fine. Typically it's gonna work fine on G0, a non-smooth. But if you go up one level, it fails. You go up second level, still fails. So we'll go back to G0. But the nice thing about this is we can actually individually adjust them. Okay, so I know for a fact that this is the only one it'll let me adjust. So let me get rid of the lines. Let me go back to G0. And as you can see, you got a real sharp transition there in the material. And if I hit it again, look at that. Super smooth transition. And that's the idea behind the continuity markers here. So G0 is just a kind of a flat linear. G1 is smooth. G2 is like super smooth. There is G3, but I don't think we're gonna get that anytime soon. So, but you'll start to run into issues if you try to see. I don't think it's gonna fail on me here. Yep, it's gonna fail. So it's just a matter of finding the right combination for it to work. So let's go ahead, Control Z. I'm going to bring my edges back. I want to show you something. So, and this continuity is only going to appear where there is, you know, an edge, basically. So if you need more, let's select him, select the face, Control R. See if I can find the center. There he is. Now, let's run that patch again. Ah, look, look what we have now. We have an additional point to play with. So let's go ahead and bring him up. Pretty much do this and this. Let's get rid of our edges so we can see it better. So, and a highlight data will let me do that. Nope. But it kind of gives you the grasp of how this works. So now we've got him in place. The one thing about lofts and patches, they don't always play nice when you're trying to fillet them. They'll pretty much fail all the time. Or you're going to get some very weird artifacts. So you almost have to, when you're doing surfacing, you almost have to build it into when you're actually creating the surface. And I'll go through that in another video. That's way beyond the scope of this one here. We'll do some advanced surface detail work there. So let's take a quick look at this handle and how I created it. All right, so let's go back to about where. So basically this was cut out of a squished cylinder. And I did like four different cuts. Cut here, cut on the bottom, a cut on the front, and a cut on the back. But I still got this very harsh curve. So let's go ahead and alleviate that. So we're going to just do a basic fillet here, just prior to it collapsing. All right. So now let's go ahead and do, I'm going to fillet that before we do any extra stuff here. Control R. Want to slice him in half, so I just have to work on one side. Do same thing over here. Now we're just working on one side. Then we can just mirror everything over. So now that we've got that, I could just do, oops, click all these faces here and shift delete. Now, as you can see, my edge, I made a nice clean transition there. So now all I have to do is hold down Alt. It'll select that boundary edge and then do my patch again. And as you can see, it's already helping out, but here's where the problem is. You can see the transition between this side to this side. So what should I do? Well, let's see what the next one looks like. Oh, looky there. Can I take it a step further? I can't. I can do a G2, kind of bulbs out a little bit, but gives a little bit of a distortion down here. Let's go back to 1. There we go. It's not so bad. And just to make sure there's not a harsh cut there. I wonder if I can do G2. That's not bad. So you compare this side to the original, and you can see it did a much better job. So now I just execute it. It's done. Let me bring back my lines. And I can go ahead and Alt X and merge halves together. Okay. Oops. What happened? Try that again. Alt X. That's weird. Huh. It's kind of weird. I don't know why that's not working. I know why. It's because I'm recording a video. That's always when it does it. Oh, well. But we'll zoom out here. We'll take a look at this guy here. But that's basically how I was able to get that smooth cut or that smooth handle there. So I was able to take it from that kind of harsh pointy side there and then turn it into this. And then I went in there, did some other cuts here, did some lofts, did some extrusions up here, down here, and I was able to have a nice little gun handle. So I hope that helped you guys out, try to demystify things a little bit for you, understand continuity a little bit better, and hopefully I can have some more advanced service in here when I'm able to describe it a little bit better. So we will catch you in the next video. You guys have a good day.